Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I will answer a very simple but important question. Before that, please subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any future Hibernate tips. Here's a question I got on my blog. I need to create a database and initialize it with a set of test data. Is there an easy way to do that with Hibernate? Yes, there is an easy way defined by the JPA specification. But before we take a closer look at it, I want to make clear that you shouldn't use it to initialize or change a production database. There are much better options for that, like Liquibase or Flyway. You can find videos about both of them on this channel. But as long as you're just looking for an easy option to prepare an example or test database, JPA got you covered. Hibernate implements the JPA standard, which defines a set of configuration parameters to set up a database. You configure them in the persistence.xml file, which you can see here. Okay, this configuration might look overwhelming at the beginning, but it's pretty simple and flexible as soon as you know the different parameters. It tells Hibernate to use two SQL scripts to drop an existing database, to create a new one, and to run an SQL script afterward to initialize it. Let's have a look at the different configuration parameters. I set the database action parameter to drop and create. That tells Hibernate to first drop and then create a new database. The parameters schema generation create source and schema generation drop source define how Hibernate shall create the database. In this example, it shall do that based on a script. And the schema generation create script source and schema generation drop script source parameters specify the location of these scripts. If you want to initialize your database with a set of test data, you can define the path to an SQL script with the SQL load script source parameter. As you have seen, the configuration isn't too complicated. The parameters follow an easy-to-understand concept, and they provide the required flexibility to create a configuration that fits your application. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!